I'm going to try to summarize very much to present a very short summary of our report in order to have probably some time for questions if you are interested on any specific issue. So I'm going to skip some things about the need or the interest of learning in computer science or things like that that all of us know. So working group. This is a working group that was formed in September of last year. It's a working group of the Spanish Computing Society, and it has also been supported, as Fran has said, by the Council of Deans and Directors of Computing. Actually, we had a hard work, but I must say that we knew what we wanted to obtain. We just wanted to adapt Spain, other recommendations in other countries, and in particular we have highlighted recommendations by the Informatics Europe and ICA in Europe, which claim that students should be competent in digital literacy in primary education, and in secondary education they should also receive information about the essence of computing. But we have to adapt this to the Spanish situation, to our laws, so it was not a straightforward action. Well, most of us were from universities, but we were lucky enough to have also some teachers from secondary education who were teaching technology and computer science, and they made a very valuable contribution. So something important is to distinguish between computing as a science and engineering. Computing is a discipline with its own concepts, methods, etc. And digital competence, which is computing, but it addresses computing as a user. Anybody can be competent, can be digitally competent, but that doesn't mean that should know much about computing. The same way as I know how to drive my car, but don't ask me about the engine or anything else for the car. In digital competence, we have adhered to the DICOMP framework, which has been adopted in Spain by the INTEF Institute. Computing has been defined in many places, for instance, ACM, with its curricular recommendations. I'm going fast, because I think I want to focus on the main ideas. And so this is our main recommendation. We, in the same way as there, if you read any educational law, you can find different matters, for instance, physical education, mathematics, etc. We propose to have a matter called informatica, computers and computing. It should be implemented as a mandatory course, which should be studied by students since primary to secondary education, including bachelorship. This is the essence of our recommendation. However, this has to be made specific into the contents of this course. And so we used several criteria, such as we wanted to give non-ambiguous recommendations so that any teacher could understand it. They should be universal. We don't want to train a genius. They should be for any student. And of course, they should be fine-tuned to the different educational stages. Our proposal contains several areas. For instance, programming, of course, digital contents, which is mostly related to digital literacy, but also others, because programming is not the only topic important to understand computing, such as computers and operating systems, networks and the internet, data and security. How did we make specific these recommendations? We gave learning goals in the style of Bloom's taxonomy, Actually, Spanish laws do not follow strictly this format. They are formed by contents, standards of evaluation and evaluation criteria, but we consider that it was not very difficult from these learning goals, which are similar to what are called here learning results. It should not be very difficult to extract the contents and also different standards. Of course, we could help in this task if necessary. But this made the task simpler for us to give just all of the proposals in only one format, which were these educational goals. I'm going to give an example. I have chosen this instead of programming because you can see two different colors. This is because what I have written in, well, I'm sorry, I have not translated the specific parts. I have been translating it before because I didn't know that I had to speak in English. So it was in Spanish, so I didn't have time to translate. But anyway, the parts which are in the learning goals, which are in blue, they are about digital competency. And the others are about computing. So we consider that all of them have to be considered in these courses, but we should be aware of which were computing and which were digital competency. We wanted to know what we were speaking always. So you may see that there is a mixture, for instance, in primary education to be able to handle digital devices. Probably it's almost trivial, but it has been must be a learning goal, and that you can see that it, between braces, if you find between parentheses 5.1, that is the specific competency in the DigiComp framework that it fits. And well, you can find others which are more technical, which are more not as a user, but as a computer scientist. If any of you have any interest, I can answer. For back zero-ship, we had a complication because there are three specialities. So we made recommendation for each specialty, and this resulted in that always there was a common part, but also there was a specific part for each one. For instance, in the programming part, we had a learning goal which was dealt with applying programming to different topics. So you may find, for instance, data analysis in the science and also in the social sciences specialties, but we don't propose this for arts. We propose something more related to artistic development. We also addressed shortly other issues, for instance, the problem with didactics. We wanted to warn that that the only way to teach programming or computing is not only projects, which is something fashionable, but we had experience at the university that only asking using projects as an assessment in the first course probably will lead to too many students failing the course. You have to use different assessment tools. But there were general recommendations, also with some examples of different kinds of exercises that are not as common but can be used. We also addressed a very important topic, which is training teachers. And here, the difficulty is that it's very different the profile of teachers in primary education and in secondary education. We are aware of this. We have made some dissemination, among them, team conference. Thank you, Frank. And we are in this phase now. We are trying to disseminate it as much as possible. And if any of you is interested, you can find them. You can copy this or you can search in Google. It's in the webpage of STIE, which is the Scientific Society, and CODI, which is the Council of Kings. I mean, it's simple. The report is in two formats. We have the complete report has 15 pages, so I don't expect you to read all of the pages, but we also have an executive summary of 2 pages. Our intent was also that if we're going to give recommendations to any politician, to any journalist, etc., it should be easy to read, so it only has 2 pages. Thank you.